Hi, my dear student friends. Welcome back to our channel. Okay. In this session, we are going to discuss about lag lead compensators. Okay. So in the previous sessions, there are certain advantages and disadvantages and the limitations of lag compensator and lead compensators. Right. So the lead compensator is mainly used to improve. Okay. Improve the rise time and the damping. Okay, damping. Also, it affects. Okay, this is the advantages. Also affects. Okay, affects the natural frequency. Okay, natural frequency of the system. Okay, plus the lag compensator improve dampingness. The lag compensator will improve the damping, the improvement, okay, improve the dampingness, but also increases the rise time, settling time, okay. So it increases, lag compensator increases settling time, okay, and rise time, okay. It increases rise time and settling time. Okay, settling time. Therefore, the combination of both, okay, combined together, used to gain the advantages, individual compensator advantages. Also, in some system, it is required to use both compensators. In some system, lag and lead. Okay, so both combination are used to get the desired result. So both are used to get the desired result. Desired result. So the lead compensator mainly used for lesser rise time. Okay, this mainly used for rise time and higher the bandwidth. Shorter the rise time. Okay, shorter the rise time and improve the bandwidth, higher bandwidth. Whereas the lag compensator is used to achieve the good damping of the system. So, because of this, we are going to combine both the lag and lead compensator together to achieve certain better result in the system. Okay, so let us consider the generalized transfer function of this GC of lag lead. Okay, so LL. Okay, lag LA GC of S for lag lead. Okay, is nothing but KC times. Okay, so S plus Z1 divided by S plus V1. So this this is related to our lead, okay, lead compensator or lag compensator. Then this is the generalized transfer function, S2 divided by S plus V2. Okay. So, for this, this is the combination of both lead lag. Okay, so this is lag. They consider this is lead. Okay, this is the generalized transfer function for lag lead compensations. So now we are going to get the generalized transfer function in the form of say GCLL lag lead. Of S equal to KC s plus here z1 equal to 1 by tau 1, z2 equal to 1 by tau 2, p1 equal to 1 by alpha tau 1, p2 equal to 1 by beta tau 2. So s plus 1 by tau 1 divided by s plus 1 by alpha times tau 1 into s plus 1 by tau 2 divided by s plus 1 by beta times tau 2. Right? So here again this can be written as, where here tau 1 tau 2 are constants and alpha is less than 1 always, we already seen according to the lag compensator. Beta is greater than 1, that is from 3 to 10, the value is 3 to 10. Then now we are going to introduce the term gamma. Okay, gamma should be greater than 1, which is nothing but alpha equal to 1 by gamma. Okay, so I consider the 1 by gamma as alpha, 1 by gamma as alpha. So now we are going to modify the relation as GCLL, lag lead equal to KC S plus 1 by tau 1 divided by S plus gamma by tau 1. Right? Similarly, here S plus 1 by tau 2, S plus 1 by beta times tau 2. So this is the modification of the transfer function. Okay. So from the this relation, the S plus, from this relation, S plus 1 by tau 1 divided by S plus 1 by alpha times tau 1, which is equal to alpha times tau 1 S plus 1 divided by alpha times tau 2 tau 1 plus 1. Right, so this contributes a lead compensator. So, okay, this is which is produces the effect of, this will produce the effect of lead compensator. Okay, this produce the effect of lead compensator. Similarly, S plus 1 by tau 2 divided by S plus 1 by beta times, okay, beta times tau 2, which is equal to beta times 1 plus tau 2 S divided by 1 plus beta times tau 2 S. Okay, so this will affect, this produces effect of, this produces effect of lag compensator. Lag compensator. So from this, according to this, this can be, sorry, this can be, this is generalized term, this is a lag, this is the lag compensator, this is lead compensator, sorry, this is lead compensator, sorry, so this is lead, this is lag. Okay, so this produces the effect of lag compensator. So what about the pole zero diagram? Okay, the pole zero diagram of the lag lead compensator is, pole zero diagram of lag lead compensator is, so this beta is a pole, okay, pole near this pole. So beta times tau 2 1 by minus 1 by, this is minus 1 by tau 2. So this 0, again this 4. So this is minus 1 by tau 1. This is minus 1 by alpha times tau 1. Okay. So here, this is the pole zero diagram of lag lead compensator. Lag lead compensator. This is the origin. Okay, origin. You see, so this is nothing but a lead. This is nothing but lag compensator. Okay, so this is the pole zero diagram of lag lead compensator. For this transfer function, so what will be the Bode plot? So the Bode diagram, okay? Bode plot. Plot for lag lead. So lag lead compensator. What is the Bode plot for lag lead compensator? Lag lead compensator. So this is gain in dB. This is magnitude plot. This is phase plot. This is phase plot. So what is the nature of the Bode plot? So one pole, one, two zeros and one pole. Okay, two zeros and one pole, which contributes the lag. Okay, the lag is a zero order transfer function. So it starts from initially a low pass filter. From this, then there is a 20 dB lag. Then from that, there is a constant term. So then again, the lead compensator produces a high pass filter. Okay. So similarly, from this 45 degree, so say this is 45 degree. Okay, then this is another minus 45 degree, minus 45 degree. So the phase lag and lead between minus 45 degree to plus 45 degree line. Okay, understand or not? Okay, from zero, so zero. Here, let's draw some more length. Omega. So let us mark this is the corner frequency. So from this corner frequency, that is 1 by beta times tau 1. This is another corner frequency. This is 1 by tau 1. This is another corner frequency. 1 by tau 2. This is another corner frequency where the shift is 1 by alpha times tau 2. Okay. So these are all corner frequencies. Here minus 20 dB per decade slow. Decay. So here plus 20 dB per decade. Understand? So these are all corner frequency. Here there are two maximums. Okay, there are two maximum. One maximum is for lag, another maximum for lead. Okay, so there are two maximum. So one maximum for lag, one maximum for lead. Say in between these two, there is a one maximum. So M1, okay, M1. For here, M2, between here, the value is M2. omega m2, here omega m1, omega m1. So this is omega m1, omega m2. So same omega m1, m2 will produce the phi m1. Okay, phi m1. So between zero, okay, from minus 45 degree to this, this is phi m1. Similarly, this line produces phi m2. So from the peak, okay. So what is the phase for the phase angle variation from zero to, so from zero it falls down, okay, it falls down to omega m2, then it goes to minus 45 degree line, then falls here. So this is, this fall is phi m2, phase angle maximum here, the phase maximum here at omega m1. So this, this magnitude is maximum m2, maximum m2. So this is omega m1. So this, this related to omega m2. So this is the Bode plot for the lag lead compensator. Bode plot for lag lead compensator. Okay. So what about the polar plot for the lag lead compensator? So we already seen the polar plot for lead compensator. The polar plot for lead compensator is starting from here. This is imaginary. This is real. Okay. So what is the polar plot for this transfer function? So from varying from so for the lead compensator, here omega equal to omega 1, that is from omega 1 to omega 1, this is omega equal to infinity. So here, from here, for lag compensator, omega equal to 0, then it reaches here, omega equal to infinity, right? So this is the polar plot for lag lead compensator, Let us see what is representation in electrical network. So the lag lead compensator electrical network, electrical network representation. Okay, so lag network, then lead network. So what is the lag? So resistor and a capacitor. Okay. So one parallel and series network, which produce the lag lead network output. So V naught of T, this is V I of T. So current I of T. So C1 R1, C2 R2. So this is the electrical network of the lag lead network. Let us do analysis using Kirchhoff's voltage law. Voltage law for both input and output. So for the input side, what is that? C1 D V naught minus VI. Sorry, DVI minus DV naught. DVI by DV naught of T divided by dt plus 1 by r1, so which is parallel here. So 1 by r1 into vi minus v0 equal to I of t. This is the I of t. Okay. So now what is dv by c1 v dv by dt. So the voltage of the circuit is given by the output voltage of the circuit, this V naught of t. So V naught of t is nothing but R2 I of t. This is also I. So this is I1, I2. So I of t plus 1 by C2 integral I dt. Integral I dt. Say equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Okay. Now apply. Let us apply the Laplace transfer function. Apply Laplace transfer function for the above, for 1 and 2. What we get for 1, so we get sc1 of vi of s minus v0 of s plus 1 by r1 of vi of s minus v0 of s equal to I of s. I of s. For the equation, this is equation number 3. What is equation number 4? V naught of S equal to R2, R2 plus 1 by S C2. Understand? Very simple. I of S. I of S. So in the equation number, this is equation number 4. From the equation number 3, we can separate input and output. Okay. Or from this I of S, we can have I of S expression. So from 4, from equation number 4, I of S becomes equal to V naught by V naught of S by R2 plus 1 by S C2. Okay. So equation number 5. So now substitute the equation number 5 in substitute equation number 5 in 3. Okay. Substitute equation number 5 in 3. We will be getting, also we can separate SC1 of VI of S minus V naught of S plus 1 by R1 VI of S minus V naught of S equal to V naught of S divided by R2 plus 1 by S C2. Am I right? So now we separate this VI and V naught one side. So this side we can write VI of S as a common term. So what will get VI of S? SC here is 1 plus R, right? So SC1 plus 1 by R1. 1 by R1. Okay, this is VI of S. Okay, this is minus R equal to, okay, minus SC1. SC1 plus V naught 1 by SC1 plus 1 by R1 V naught of S, which is equal to V naught of S divided by R2 plus 1 by SC2. Just we are separating the VI and V naught here. Now we can bring these two to the other side, right? So by bringing that equation to the other side, or we can bring this form into this side. Okay, can bring this to left hand side by multiplying this into every term. So what we will get? So SC1 will multiply here. So what I am getting is SC1 plus 1 by R1 multiply by this term. Okay, multiply by R2 plus 1 by SC2 into VI, right? V of S. Okay. Then it is equal to V naught of S. Okay. So we take this term, we can bring it to that side. So V naught of S here only V naught one plus here multiplication of these two SC1 plus 1 by R1 okay into R2 plus 1 by SC2 So this is the manipulation we made. Okay, now we are going to isolate the take LCM for these two terms. So for this 1 plus R C1 for this term, 1 plus S R1 C1 divided by R1. Here 1 plus SC2 R2. So here 1 SC2 in the denominator. So what we are going to write here, 1 plus S R1 C1 into 1 plus S R2 C2 divided by S R1 C2 VI of S. Right, which is equal to V naught of S. Similarly, we can take LCM here. So 1 plus S R1 C1 into 1 plus S R2 C2. Right, divided by S R1 C2. S R1 C2. Right? S R1 C2. So, from this relation, what we are going to do is we are going to bring this format, that is transfer function format, Laplace transform of output to Laplace transform of input. So the solution becomes very simple. What I am going to get here is 1 plus S R1 C1, 1 plus S R2 C2 divided by, say, taking this LCM here. So what we are getting here, S R1 C2 plus, okay, 1 plus S R1 C1 into 1 plus S R2 C2. Am I right? So I am getting this expression. So what I am going to manipulate is just taking R1 C1, R2 C2. Okay. So multiplying these two terms. So I am going to manipulate this transfer function as, so numerator content will be same, S R1 C1 1 plus S R2 C2. So the denominator, okay, denominator I am going to separate in terms of S. Okay, so just multiplying these two factors, and I am going to put in the order of the second order transfer function. So what I am getting is, so S square R1 R2 C1 C2 plus S of R1 C1 plus R2 C2 plus R1 C2, okay, plus 1. So I am getting into this format. So from this, I am going to take R1 C1 in the numerator and R2 C2 also from the numerator. So what I am getting here is, so if I remove in the numerator, so V0 by VI, V0 of S by V of S. So here we take R1 C1 as a common term, R1, R1 C1 and R2 C2 in the numerator, okay, common term, understand? So what we get, so I am getting this V0 of S to VI of S as 1 plus 1 plus, sorry, S plus 1 by tau 1, S plus 1 by tau 2 divided by, listen. So the when I take in the numerator, so here when I take R1 as a common term here, so this term will be R1 C1 S plus 1 by R1 C1. It will be like this. Similarly for all factors. So here I will get S plus 1 by R1 C1 S plus 1 by R2 C2 divided by, so since R1 C1 into R2 C2 I am taking outside, so the denominator contains the R1 C1 C2, this cancel. So I will be getting only S square term, S square plus S into 1 by R1 C1 plus 1 by R2 C2 plus 1 by R1 R2 C1 plus 1 by R1 R2 C1 C2. That's all, very simple. So this is the final representation of the transfer function for lag lead compensator. So now the G of GC of lag lead, it becomes S plus 1 by tau 1, S plus 1 by tau 1, S plus 1 by tau 2 divided by, okay, so divided by S square plus S into, I'm going to introduce, already introduced alpha equal to 1 by gamma equal to 1 by alpha, this divided by tau 1 plus 1 divided by beta tau 2, okay, plus gamma by beta tau 1 tau 2. This is the final representation. That, okay, where you can ask me the question, tau 1 equal to R1 C1, tau 2 equal to R2 C2. Then there is the relation gamma by tau 1 plus 1 by beta tau 2 equal to 1 by R1 C1 plus 1 by R2 C2 plus 1 by R2 C1. So which from this, I'm going to consider gamma by beta equal to gamma by beta into tau 1 tau 2 equal to r1 r2 c1 c2 and beta should be equal to gamma. Okay, so it is noted that the values of beta and gamma should be same for lag lead compensator. This value should be same for lag lead compensator. Understand or not? So next, so what is the effect of lag lead compensator? Effects of lag lead compensator. So what are the various effects? So this gives, because of using both compensators, it gives fast, both fast response, good static accuracy is required. Okay, when used when both the compensators, so used when both the fast response, the speed response and good static accuracy for a system is required. Okay, so because of using both, increases low frequency gain and improves steady state. Increases low frequency gain. Okay, and improves steady state. Okay, also it increases the bandwidth. So increases the bandwidth of the system. Hence faster response of the system. Okay, these are all effects of lag lead compensator. Okay, so these are all the important concept behind the lag lead compensator. Okay.